Hello, welcome. This is Birdy. Welcome to a new lesson in Houdini. Today we continue our journey in the Pyro series in Houdini. Today we will explain how the system works for the fire simulation in Houdini, and we will dig deeper under the hood. So let's get started. So let's start, guys. Today we will take how the ignite or composition take place in Houdini and also how the system work for the fire. So let's get started. Let's make a sphere. We'll do the same procedure, same node tree. We're not going to do something different. Okay, so let's make a pyro source. Of course, to have this menu, just hit tab on the keyboard or right click by the mouse. Okay, in case you don't know. So let's choose pyro solver. Oh, I'm sorry, not the pyro solver. Pyro source, pyro source. Okay, here we go. Now we have the pyro source. Now by default the initialize is on source fuel, but it doesn't give us anything, so let's change it to source smoke. Delete both of this and go back to source fuel. Now we have two attributes, fuel and temperature. They work same as the density and the temperature. If you see the last lesson for the smoke sourcing, right, in the pyro series. So please, for who didn't watch this the previous lesson, go and watch the previous lesson before this lesson for the pyro series. Okay, so now as we can see, we have fuel attribute and temperature attribute same as the smoke. I explained this before, so let's convert it to a volume rasterize attribute. Same workflow, just we will type the fuel, also we'll type the temperature. Yeah, so now we got two fields, as we can see, the fuel and the temperature. But of course we need more particles. Maybe we can do this also, you know something. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, so here, as we can see, we don't have any particle because we choose keep input, and the input we have only had one point because we choose the primitive. So you can go here and change it to surface scatter. Now we will have a surface scatter, right? So now we don't need to do anything more. I apologize for the noise in the background. My neighbor doing things on their apartment, and I'm not sure when they will finish. Okay, so now we can do something else. We can copy parameter, copy the voxel size here and paste it here, so all will be synchronized. Paste relative reference. Yes, like this. Okay, so now we have voxel 0.5. as we can see, it's a little big. We can control it by the pixel particle scale. Okay, like this, maybe something like this. Okay, also we can make it maybe 0.5 to have more p scale. Let's type it to null. Let's name it out, or let's say yeah, okay, out fire source. Okay, R to move to put the display render. Okay, by R, hitting R. So let's make a dop network type this fire source, and this fire simulation. Okay, now we'll go inside the fire simulation. Let's make a pyro solver right here. Let's make a smoke object. We don't have a pyro object, we only have a smoke object. I'm not sure why they name it as a smoke object, but we have only one smoke object. Okay, also let's make the volume source. Let's connect it here to see initial view. Yeah, even here we can connect it with a fuel sub pass and temperature, and the same as the smoke. Okay, but we will use the volume source. Now let's connect it to the out source for the fire, which contain the fuel and temperature fields. Okay, we are in the smoke source, but we need to be in the source fuel to have all the attribute we need, or field we need to ignite the fuel or to have a fire. Okay, so now let's explain what's happening under the hood. So I will just, at the beginning we have something called the fuel. This is ignite. I'm sorry for the bad text. Ignite in, or ignition in Houdini. Okay, this is explaining of the ignition in Houdini. What's happening? We have a fuel source, or we have a fuel. Okay, this called fuel. Okay, this is fuel. Okay, then to ignite a fuel you need a temperature, right? So we have a temperature also. We have a temperature also, like this. This called temperature. This is temperature. Okay, now what happened when same as in the nature, when you want to ignite a fuel, doesn't matter the type of the fuel. It can be wood, it can be gas, it can be oil, any, it doesn't really matter, but it's just a fuel. Okay, so you need a temperature to ignite this fuel, right? In nature, there is a certain degree to ignite a fuel. I'm not sure what the degree. Maybe maybe 200 degree or something like this. Maybe, I'm not sure. But in Houdini, there is no specific degree for the temperature. You are the one who choose it. Okay, but it's by default 0.1. Any temperature has a value of 0.1 is valid to ignite the fuel. Okay, we have it here. I think we have it here in the here. I think we have it here. Yeah, ignite temperature, as we can see here. Okay, so for the first step we must have a fuel and a temperature. It doesn't have, we don't need to have a temperature, but because temperature will take place in the dopnetwork itself, even if we don't have a temperature. Okay, so but let's say second we must have a temperature. So next, what is happening when the temperature started to ignite the fuel? It converts the fuel to something called burn, or the burnt fuel. Okay, so we have something here called let's say this, the fuel now will become burn something like this, or burn it, let's say burn it fuel. Okay, so the fuel becoming burn it now, burn it fuel. So after this step, is three. What's happening? This step is three. So when the fuel burn it, it emit two things. Emit something called heat. Let's choose another color. It emit something called heat. This is heat. Heat. Okay, and heat is the flame. So heat is the flame. In the in Houdini, the heat field, the heat is the field. This is the name of the field, the flame field. It's called heat. This is what we render. So this is the heat or the flame. The heat is the flame. Okay, but in Houdini, it's field called heat. Okay, so when the fuel burned by ignite temperature, it give us burned fuel, and this burned fuel emit heat. Okay, so the heat is the flame. Okay. So after certain degree for the heat, it can when it reach a degree, a temperature degree, it converted to smoke. So it cut off to a smoke. So we have here smoke. This is called smoke, and the smoke is the of course the density. Sorry for the density is the smoke, as we know. Okay, so its field name in Houdini in the dopnetwork called density. And it is the smoke. It gives us the smoke. Density is the smoke. Okay. So this will be four, five. Okay. So the heat in a certain degree, when it's above a certain degree, it converts to a density. Okay. So this is the process. Also, we have other temperature that when the fuel turn to burnt fuel, it give us more. It give us, it emit more temperature, plus temperature. Okay. So in this process, when the fuel ignite to burn it fuel, or when it burn, okay, when it converted to burn fuel, it emit also temperature. Okay, and this temperature of course rise the flame more and more. Okay, and also last thing, it give us a gas, a release gas. It release a gas. Let's choose maybe this one. A release gas here. A release gas. Okay. And this called gas. And this gas also help the simulation to has more fire. Okay, and we control it. Okay, so simply this is the ignition in Houdini. So let's see it in Houdini. Now we choose the source fuel. Okay, we have now fuel and we have temperature. Okay, target fuel must name fuel. It cannot be any name else. Source fuel can be any name, but you have to define it in the sourcing itself. Okay, so the name you choose in the sourcing here, this name fuel and temperature, you must choose it, you must use it. Okay, but the target field is the field in the simulation itself. It will take over and advect in the simulation itself. The advection itself, this process itself, the advection is the field moving. Let's say we have we have the domain. This is the domain. Okay, we have in every voxel we have temperature, we have fuel, we have heat, we have burn, we have every field we have here. Every field we have here. We have it in every voxel. It's value. Okay. So when the advect happened, the value for every field changed to other value in the other voxel. Okay. And its value, original value in this voxel, will change too. So the process of the advect itself, or the simulation itself, this is called the advect. Okay? But the voxel doesn't move. The field itself, the amount of the field, it is the thing which is moving. So let's continue. Now if I press play, I don't have anything. Why? Because I need to have the as we can see here in the Pyro in the fire simulation, as we can see here, the domain doesn't is very small. So it must be big. This is the first step. Also, we need the gas. Maybe just we need the gas resize fluid dynamic, just to control the size of the domain of the smoke object. Okay. Here we don't need a clamp to the maximum. Maybe we just need to check this and check all this, unless the Y axis. Let's hit play. Still have nothing. Okay, this is the first thing. The second, we need to have heat here as well. Heat as well, because it will search for a heat and density. And maybe we don't have a density, but we have a heat, because now we are ignite. We have a composition here. We are igniting. So it will search for the heat. Okay. I think it must search for the fuel, not the heat. Yeah, but this is inside the dopnetwork itself. But here the tracking object must search for anything, think value. Let's choose this. Okay. Yeah. So as we can see here now, is something happening. I will hide this. I apologize for the noise in the background. Okay. So let's continue now. maybe we press D and we move it to the dark background. And okay, let's see what we got here. So far we have the mushroom effect, but also we have something rising, the smoke rising. Why? Because now we just see the density itself, we see the smoke itself. Okay, as we can see here, we see the density itself, but we have fuel. We can now see the fuel. This is the fuel that we have. As we can see now, we have a fuel. Okay, this is the fuel field that burn. This the fuel field that we importing from the sourcing to the target fuel here. Okay, also we have the burned fuel here. As we can see, this is the burned fuel. We have the burned fuel as well, the fuel that burned. Yeah, this is the fuel before it burned, and this is the burned fuel or the burn. Okay, then we have the heat. As I said, we have the heat. This is the heat. This is the flame that will give us the color of the fire. Okay, and we have also the density or the smoke. As we can see, not all the smoke is fire, but when it reach a certain point, it converted to a smoke. The fire turned to a smoke. Okay, and also we can, if we want, we can just stop emit smoke. We're not going to have a smoke. As we can see now, we don't have any smoke. All we have is just the flame itself. Flame itself, like the oven, for example, the fire of the oven. It's we have a flame, but without a smoke, right? So it depends. Okay. Also, we have the temperature, that we have the original temperature, that then the temperature that is added by the burned fuel itself. Okay, if we make this zero, we will have only the temperature that is being added, as we can see here, temperature that is being added, but we don't have a fuel, or we don't have a fuel, right? So let's, of course, I think we should, if you want to see the temperature, I think it must be temperature. Can do this here. Temperature. Yeah. So as we can see now, we have also a temperature in the gas recycler, so it will search also for the temperature field, and it will resize the domain for the smoke object again, because now we have it will search for all these three things. We don't have a heat because we don't have a fuel anymore. If I choose this, we don't have a heat. We don't have a burn. All of this because we don't have a fuel. But since we have a fuel, we will have heat again, and burn and fuel and all this. Okay. Plus the temperature. Okay. That burning from the ignite for the fuel. Okay, so I don't need to see that. And see, there's when we use fire, we usually use multi fields. It's better to use multi field. And now we can, of course, the smoke, we have the density for the smoke. We don't need to put a density diffuse field here, but in the emission field we can put the temperature. Temperature, yes, and of course the emission scale must be 1. So let's check what we have here. Yeah, but it's still white. We have something, but still white. Why? Because the emission color, we don't have any emission color. So we type heat. as we can see now, it will look in the color field will be from the heat itself, from the heat field, okay, as we can see now. And of course we can change all this. We can maybe can make this here. You can change it as you want. Maybe black here, maybe black here, maybe again here, maybe something like this, and also maybe something like this, as we can see now. Maybe you can control it as we want, but it looks a little weird, so I will keep it to the default for now, okay. So of course we also can use the heat here, then the temperature. You can type heat here. So this is a different, the emission field will be from the heat, not the temperature. And also here even we can use a temperature, but it will give us other results. As we can see here, it's become very intense, or exposure, right? Exposure. So we are good for now. So I think that was for the explaining the ignite model in the Pyro simulation. And that was it for this lesson. I hope you enjoyed. If you have any question, please type it in the comment section below the video. Also, don't forget to like the video and subscribe for the channel and share it with your friends. And I see you in the next lesson. Have a good day.